Lord's people on this holiday weekend, and welcome to Good Shepherd Lutheran Church as we gather for worship. Nice to have you joining with us, and a special welcome to our visitors with us today. God's blessings upon you as we worship together. Our order of service for this morning is going to be the Divine Service Setting Number 4. That will be on page 203 in the front portion of your hymnal. Our opening hymn for today is hymn 907, God Himself is Present, and we will stand on the third and final verse.
By His authority, I therefore forgive you all your sins in the name of the Father,
and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our intro for this day is printed in your worship folder from Psalm chapter 29, and we will read it responsibly by verse. Ascribe to the Lord, O heavenly beings, ascribe to the Lord glory and strength. The voice of the Lord is over the waters. The God of glory thunders. The Lord over many waters. The voice of the Lord breaks the cedars. The Lord breaks the cedars of Lebanon. The voice of the Lord flashes forth flames of fire. The voice of the Lord makes the deer give birth and strips the forest bare, and in his temple all cry, glory. May the Lord give strength to his people. May the Lord bless his people with peace. We continue now in our service of the word with the Kyrie at the top of page 204. For those who labor, for those whose work is difficult or dangerous, and for all who travel, let us pray to the Lord. For all those in need, for the hungry and homeless, for the widowed and orphaned, and for all those in prison, let us pray to the Lord.
Thank you.
Let us pray. Holy God, our Father, dwelling in majesty and filling creation with your Spirit, reveal your glory through our Lord Jesus Christ, cleanse us from doubt and fear, and send us boldly into all the world to worship you, with the Son and the Holy Spirit, one God, living and reigning, now and forever. Amen. Please be seated.
The Old Testament reading for this Holy Trinity Sunday is found in Isaiah chapter 6, verses 1 through 8, and is printed on the back of your worship folder. In the year that King Uzziah died, I saw the Lord sitting upon a throne, high and lifted up, and the train of his robe filled the temple. Above him stood the seraphim. Each had six wings. With two he covered his face, and with two he covered his feet. And with two he flew. And one called to another and said, Holy, holy, holy is the Lord of hosts. The whole earth is full of his glory. And the foundations of the threshold shook at the voice of him who called, and the house was filled with smoke. And I said, Woe is me, for I am lost, for I am a man of unclean lips, and I dwell in the midst of a people of unclean lips. For my eyes have seen the King, the Lord of hosts. Then one of the seraphim flew to me, having in his hand a burning coal that he had taken with the tongs from the altar. And he touched my mouth and said, Behold, this has touched your lips. Your guilt is taken away, and your sin atoned for. And I heard the voice of the Lord saying, Whom shall I send, and who will go for us? Then I said, Here am I, send me. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God. The second reading on this Holy Trinity Sunday is in Acts, the second chapter, verse 14a and 22-36, also printed on the back of your worship folder, and read the verses together as a congregation. We read, Peter, standing with the 11, lifted up his voice and addressed them, Men of Israel, hear these words, Jesus of Nazareth, a man attested to you by God, with mighty works and wonders and signs that God do through him in your midst, as you yourselves know. This Jesus, delivered up according to the evident plan and foreknowledge of God, you crucified and killed by the hands of lawless men. God raised him up, loosing the pangs of death, because it was not possible for him to be held by it. For David says concerning him, I saw the Lord always before me, for he is at my right hand, that I may not be shaken. Therefore my heart was glad, and my tongue rejoiced. My flesh also will dwell in hope, for you will not abandon my soul to Hades, or let your Holy One see corruption. You have made known to me the path of life. You will make me full of gladness with your presence. Brothers, I may say to you with confidence about the patriarch David, that he both died and was buried, and his tomb is with us to this day. Being therefore a prophet, and knowing that God had sworn with an oath to him that he would set one of his descendants on his throne, he foresaw and spoke about the resurrection of the Christ, that he was not abandoned to Hades, nor did his flesh see corruption. This Jesus God raised up, and of that we are all witnesses, being therefore exalted at the right hand of God, and having received from the Father the promise of the Holy Spirit, he has poured out this that you yourselves are seeing and hearing. For David did not ascend into the heavens, but he himself said, The Lord said to my Lord, Sit at my right hand, until I make your enemies your footstool. Let all the house of Israel, therefore, know for certain that God has made him both Lord and Christ, this this Jesus whom you crucified. This is the word of the Lord. Will you please rise to the Holy Gospel?
Also, are we prohibited by the Catholic religion to
say that there are three gods or lords. The Son is neither made nor created, but begotten of the Father alone.
The Holy Spirit is the Father of the Son, neither made nor created.
Thus there is one Father, not three fathers, one Son, not three sons, one Holy Spirit, not three Holy Spirits. But the whole three persons are co-eternal with each other and co-equal, so that in all things, as has been stated above, the Trinity in unity and unity in Trinity is to be worshipped. But it is also necessary for everlasting salvation that one faithfully believe the incarnation of our Lord Jesus Christ. He is God, begotten from the substance of the Father before all ages, and he is man, born from the substance of his mother in this age. Equal to the Father with respect to his divinity, less than the Father with respect to his humanity. One, however, not by the conversion of the divinity into flesh, but by the assumption of the humanity into God. Whereas the rational soul and flesh is one man, so God and man is one Christ. Ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father, God Almighty, from whence he will come to judge the living and the dead. And those who have done good will enter into eternal life, and those who have done evil into eternal fire. Please be seated. died so we might live. Amen. Text will serve as the base of our message for this morning as our Old Testament lesson from Isaiah chapter 6, 1 through 8. Dear friends of Christ, many of you know that I enjoy the study of people, especially groups of people. And one such group is the Mafia. I watch all the shows on cable about Luciano and Gotti, Arcado and Giancana and Anastasia. And you see, if you testify against these types of men, you need to be protected. And starting in 1970, the government came up with a program, the Federal Witness Protection Program. They change your address, your occupation, your name, and anything else that might identify you. You hide from who you used to be. You testify in court, and then you clam up to stay alive. The Lord in our text was looking for someone just as bold. But this job description did not include hiding from your witness. It would include calling out a whole nation. It would take a prophet. How about you? How bold are you? Are you prepared to confront the idolaters of our nation? Do you recognize your own sinful shortcomings? Do you want to go in hiding? Are you in the witness protection program? The text begins in the year that King Uzziah died. Now you have to go to 2 Chronicles 26, and it gives us a glimpse of who this king was. He ruled for 52 years. During his reign, the economy blossomed. Unemployment and taxes were low. Military victories happened. Judah was experiencing good times. Ain't we lucky we got them? Good times. And all this, though, led to a lowering of moral standards. And after Uzziah died, the Assyrian threat made the future look bleak. Does any of this sound familiar? Our economy's on the upswing. Unemployment's low, certain taxes are declining. But what about our moral standards? Drugs being legalized, values being questioned, marriage being flushed down the sewer of postmodern relativism, safe zones being created while young people get shot in the school library. Isaiah knew that in spite of the problems, God was still in charge. He saw the Lord sitting on his throne in our text, and God is still on his throne. He's directing the course of the world in his own wise way. And Isaiah's vision was part of the Lord's plan. God was going to need a witness, but he didn't need a self-righteous one. Seeing God's majesty and glory and hearing the worship offered by the angels, Isaiah was overwhelmed by his own sinfulness. He responded by confessing his sins and the sins of his nation. You see, in our culture, most see themselves as just individuals. But Isaiah's confession reflects the more scriptural view of society. We belong to one another. Each of us contributes to the whole. We retain individual responsibility for the direction of our own lives, but we also share jointly in the responsibility of the direction our society takes. God provided the cleansing for Isaiah. His unclean lips were atoned for and his guilt taken away. He was then ready to enter the Lord's witness protection program. Now before our commission, we too stand before the Lord with unclean lips and hearts and actions. You know, Isaiah felt so bad about his sins, he thought he was going to die from his encounter with the Lord. Do your sins ever do that to you? We come face to face with our guilt and know there is no way to pay the penalty. And we don't have to. You see, through Jesus, God has provided our forgiveness. He baptizes us through the Holy Spirit and through the word of the gospel, which tells us of Jesus Christ and what he has done. We are cleansed from our unclean lips through faith created by the Holy Spirit, working through word and sacrament. We trust that forgiveness and salvation. Now, can I get a witness? The Lord got one. He became the most quoted Old Testament writer in the New Testament. He declared God's judgment and promise of salvation, the coming Savior. To hear and respond to this message is what Isaiah's world needed. His assignment wouldn't be easy. He would name names. He would confront. After a while, people would cross the street when they saw him coming. And eventually, if tradition tells the truth, his own people would saw him in half. Can our world get your witness? Hiding behind a new identity is not an option. You are a Christian, a follower of the Savior Jesus Christ. You are clothed in his righteousness. Will you love and chastise, confront and forgive? The idolatry is so immense in our society, and the task difficult, but remember, the Lord is in charge of your protection. He may not be asking you to preach like Peter in our reading from Acts this morning, but he is encouraging your witness. He asks you to scatter the seed in your speaking about the good news. The world, or the word, will create the faith. Jesus is on the stage even as the Holy Spirit is behind the scenes making it happen. He's in the rafters putting the spotlight on Jesus. So may we too in our lives and conversations remain focused on Christ, proclaiming the simple, beautiful news of his birth, death, and resurrection. Here am I. Send me. Send me. Amen. Please rise for the prayer of the church. I will conclude each petition with the words, Lord, in your mercy, will you, as the congregation of our Lord Savior Jesus Christ, please respond, hear our prayer. O eternal and unchangeable God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, with angels and archangels we laud and magnify your holy name. Accept our praise this day for creating us, preserving us, redeeming us, and delivering us to your forgiveness and salvation. In your mercy, Almighty God, you bless the earth to make it fruitful, bringing forth in abundance whatever is needed for the support. support of our lives. Prosper the work of farmers and all those who labor to bring food to our table. As you will, bring moisture to our land where needed, and let us proclaim your goodness with thanksgiving. Lord, in your mercy, Lord Jesus, visit those who are in any type of distress with the assurance that you abide with them in their infirmities, especially remembering Doris Hoffman, who underwent outpatient surgery this past week and is facing another surgery, and her custodian Roman, as he looks forward to getting back to work later this week after his knee replacement surgery. Grant deliverance, peace, and healing. Lord, in your mercy. On this weekend, O Lord, when our nation remembers those who have given their lives to preserve the freedoms we enjoy, we honor their sacrifice and beg you to ever guard and defend this country from every evil. Protect and guide those who travel as they enjoy the beauty of your creation. Lord, in your mercy. Dear Lord, you have brought our high school and college graduates to the goal of their formal education. Your holy word has been a guide and help, and the Holy Spirit has given them faith and strength and ability to reach the goal of graduation. As they face the future, assure them of your guidance and blessing for the days ahead, and a keen sense of their calling through Christ, their Savior and Lord. Lord, in your mercy. Father of an infinite majesty, hear our prayers for the sake of your adorable, true, and only Son, Jesus Christ, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, now and forever. Amen. Our worship continues at the top of page 208, the service of the sacrament preface. The Lord be with you. Lift up your heart. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly good, right, and salutary. We should at all times and in all places give thanks to you, O Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Everlasting God, for the countless blessings you so freely bestow on us and all creation. Above all, we give thanks for your boundless love shown to us when you sent your only begotten Son, Jesus Christ, into our flesh, and laid on him our sin, giving him into death, that we might not die eternally. Because he is now risen from the dead and lives and reigns to all eternity, all who believe in him will overcome sin and death, and will rise again to new life. Therefore, with angels and archangels, and with all the company of heaven, we laud and magnify your glorious name, evermore praising you and singing. Blessed are you, O Lord our God, King of all creation, for you have had mercy on us, and given your only begotten Son, that whoever believes in him should not perish, but have eternal life. You once revealed your name to Moses in the burning bush, and through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, you unveiled the mystery of your holy name in the Trinity of persons and the unity of being. Grant that we baptize and instructed in the triune name may faithfully eat and drink of your Son's body and blood, and worship you in spirit and truth. O Father, through your Son in the Holy Spirit, hear us as we pray in his name and as he has taught us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever. Amen. Our Lord Jesus Christ, on the night when he was betrayed, took bread. When he had given thanks, he gave it to the disciples and said, "Take, eat. This is my body, which is given for you. This do in remembrance of me." In the same way, also he took the cup after supper. When he had given thanks, he gave it to them, saying, "Drink of it, all of you. This cup is the New Testament in my blood, which is shed for you for the forgiveness of sins. This do as often as you drink it in remembrance of me." The peace of the Lord be with you always.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Good morning and welcome. This is graduation weekend for us, so my mother-in-law is here along with three of Tony's aunts, and we welcome them. They came down from Minnesota. Tony's mom is here from Texas, and our hot water heater went out. So, and nobody has a part on a holiday weekend. So we have been making do with the people we have. Now the aunts are in a hotel, so some of the ladies went over there last night. And we've had it looked at and everything, but the part we can't get for a day or two, so we're all just trying to survive. And I know I said this in the early service, and my father-in-law said I was calling him out, and I wasn't. So I don't want my mother-in-law to feel this way, but this is the second time our hot water heater has gone out when my mother-in-law and father-in-law have been at our house. What are the chances of that, huh? They got to be astronomical. So anyway, if I wasn't myself today, it's because I live for a hot shower. I feel the hot water heater is the greatest invention ever. And so we are just dealing with it the best we can. But anyway, this afternoon, Holden has a graduation party 2 to 5 at GE Clubhouse. We'd love to have you come by. We'll have a lot of good things there, food and drink and air conditioning. And we'd love to see you this afternoon on behalf of Holden. So, and congratulations to our other graduates, too. I know we have some college graduates here and everything. So God's blessings to all of you.
Good morning. As Pastor said, we'd like to welcome our guests and visitors today. And if you haven't done so yet, please sign our guest book on the way out and introduce yourself to Pastor. Please look over the yellow portion of your service folder for the upcoming activities and events. I'd like to point out a couple of them. On June 10th, Good Shepherd's having a group night out at the Corn Belt baseball field. And if you want tickets, please see Randy Reinhardt after the service, and he can get tickets for you. It's a good deal. It's $10, and that includes a $5 food voucher. So it's a good deal for that. The other is July 14th and 15th, and really the 13th also. It's going to be a busy weekend. The 13th is going to be movie night. Everyone's invited for that. We're going to have a good movie for that. On the 14th, there's a blood drive down here. So if you haven't given blood, mark that down, and you can give blood. And we're going to have a brunch. We'll have breakfast food, and lunch food for that. And then on the 15th, we're having a special service outside under the tent up at our North 40 to celebrate. We're paying off half of our mortgage, so we're down $2 million. So everyone, mark that on your calendar. We're going to have a community service out there, and everyone's invited for that. Are there any other announcements?